Good morning, dear students. We have studied about the economic reforms since 1991, and also we have studied about the objectives of economic reforms. In economic reforms, we studied that there are three major steps that has been taken place. That is called liberalization, privatization, and globalization. And the next topic that we have studied is the objective of economic reforms, for how or why these economic reforms have been made. Now we are going to study the next topic, that is called the major steps of the economic reforms, how this economic reforms came into existence. Okay, so in this, the first topic that we have to study is the new industrial policy. The under industrial policy, keeping in view the priorities of the country and its economic development, the basic roles of the public and the private sector are clearly decided. Under the new industrial policy, the industries have been freed to a large extent from the license and controls. In order to encourage modernization, the stress has been laid upon the use of latest technology. A great reduction has been effected in the role of the public sector. Efforts have been made to encourage foreign investment. So there are a lot of activities performed in this stage. So here we can see that the new industrial policy, so the industrial policy of the government has been changed. A new industrial policy has been brought up. So in this new industrial policy, keeping in view the previous priorities of the country and its economic development, the roles of the public and private sectors are clearly decided. So here, in the new industrial policy, what role the public sector has to take and what role the private sector has to take, it is clearly mentioned, or it is clearly decided. And another thing, the industries have been freed to a large extent from the license and other controls. So earlier there was a lot amount of restrictions and controls for the private sector to start up a company and for running a company. But in the new industrial policy, the restrictions have been removed. All these controls have, all we cannot say, there are licenses are there as well as the controls are there, but to some extent these controls have been reduced. And in order to encourage modernization, stress has been laid upon the use of latest technology. So as a part of modernization, in order to bring modernization, modern means to bring it something new, so newness in the production, for bringing newness in the production, new technologies has been implemented. Okay, so permission was given for bringing up new technologies, even purchasing technologies from abroad, or bringing machineries from abroad, or importing. All these permissions were given. Earlier this type of permissions were not there. And a great reduction has been effected in the role of the public sector. So the role of the public sector has been reduced to a very high amount. So means very reduced to a very low amount, means public sector's role has reduced, and more role is given to the private sector. And efforts have been made to encourage foreign investment. Another change is that more efforts have been given to increase the foreign investment. So these are the steps or the actions taken in the first step, that is called the new industrial policy. The next step is called the new trade policy. Okay, so new trade policy have been made. The trade policy means the policy through which the foreign trade is controlled and regulated. So how the foreign trade is controlled and regulated, that is the trade policy. Okay, as a result of the liberalization, trade policy has undergone tremendous changes. Especially the foreign trade has been freed from the unnecessary controls. The age-old restrictions have been eliminated at one go. So earlier there was a lot amount of restrictions for inviting foreign investment. So people were companies, those who are running they were unable to invite foreign investments, and these restrictions have been changed. So people from foreign country also can invest, or companies from foreign country can invest money in our country, and we can also invest money in the foreign country. So the limitations or control has been reduced. Okay, the next one, the third step, is called as the fiscal reforms. Okay, the policy of the government connected with the income and expenditure is called the fiscal policy. The fiscal policy means that the government's policy towards the income and expenditure of the government. Okay, so what income, how much income will be there, and out of that how much expenditure will be there, how much income and how much expenditure, all these things are there. So this is called the fiscal policy, and lot of changes have been made in the fiscal policy. Also, the greatest problem confronting the Indian government is excessive fiscal deficit. So the fiscal deficit means that more expenses. Okay, the expenses over the income is higher. Okay, sometimes it means it is almost, fiscal deficit means we can say loss. Okay, the expenditure is more than the income. If we have 100 rupees income and 120 rupees expenditure, that is, and 20 rupees is the deficit, we can say. Do you understand? So here India was in such a situation, and we can say the fiscal deficit was 3.5%. Means that if 100 rupee income is there, means GDP is there, then 103.5 rupees expenditure is there. Means 3.5% expenditure. Means 100 rupees means, I am just telling as an example, it is in a big, very huge amount, very big, crores of rupees are there. So 3.5% is it will come, means 350 crores or even very higher amounts are there. Okay, it is important to understand the meaning of fiscal deficit and the GDP. So now we need to know, when you have to understand about fiscal reforms, we have to understand what is fiscal deficit and what is GDP. A fiscal deficit means the country is spending more than its income. Okay, so I told you, the income of the country will be less and expenditure is more than the income. Now see, like if this coronavirus situation is there, so we can say that the country is facing such kind of problems. Always the country is facing this kind of problem, always the fiscal deficit is there. Because India is like a developing country, and we don't have sufficient amount of income, and expenditures are more. We have to spend more money in the way of different methods, different ways are there that we have to spend, and we need to, in economics you will be studying the details about this one, how this fiscal deficit will be coming, or how much income, what are the different sources of income that we are receiving, and how much expenditures we are having. Okay, all these type of things we will study in economics. The next topic, thing that we have to understand is that the gross domestic product, the GDP, this you may be familiar. The GDP is the sum total of the financial value of all the produced goods and services during a year in a country. So within a year, how much is the total products, good product, entire amount of products and goods and services that were produced within the country during a year, that is called the GDP, gross domestic product. So the fiscal deficit is calculated based on all the, most of the like policies and other kind of things are decided based on the GDP, how much is our GDP, and how much percentage of the GDP is to be spent on the different purposes like that. So we can, the fiscal deficit is calculated based on the GDP, and in 1991 the 3.5% of GDP was fiscal deficit, means more than the income. 3.5% more than the income was spent. The next one, next topic is the monetary reforms. The monetary reforms, monetary policy is a sort of a control through which the central bank controls the supply of money with a view to achieving the objective of the general economic policy. The reforms in this policy are called monetary policy. So the monetary policy means that how the country is controlling, the central bank is controlling the money supply of a country. Okay, so this also we have to study in economics, like how the country central bank is controlling the money supply. So sometimes the money supply will be like the demand for the products will be very much low, then we have to increase the money supply. So for that the central bank is reducing the bank interest rates, so then money supply will increase. And when demand is very much high, means that the money supply is more in the country, so then the bank will be reducing the interest. And there are so many other policies are there by the central bank will control. So this is called as a monetary policy. And these policies, there will be some kind of changes in the what are the changes in the monetary policy, means the monetary reforms. All these points will come under the monetary reforms. Okay, the next topic that we have to study is about the capital market reforms. Okay, so the capital market reforms means that the market in which securities are sold and bought is known as the capital market, where we are selling, buying and selling of the securities. So such a market is called as the capital market, and the reforms connected with the, it are known as the capital market reforms. This market is the pivot of economy of a country. The government has taken the following steps for the development of this market. So we can understand, like, in order to understand the this is a like we can understand from the capital market conditions, or we can say like sensex, Nifty, all these type of things are there. Index numbers are there. By looking at the index numbers, this type of index numbers, we can understand what is the situation of a country. Okay, so different countries will have different sorts of index numbers, and capital market indexes are there. So in the point of view of that, when you see the point, we can understand that what is the condition of the country. So if a country is in a good position, then the capital market will be in a higher position, and if a country is in a problematic situation, then the capital market of the country also will be little in problem. Okay, so there are some steps taken by the government for controlling the capital markets. So these are called in order to control the capital market, the Securities and Exchange Board of India has been established. SEBI, you might have heard about this one. So the Securities and Exchange Board of India, so in order to control the capital market. So earlier, there are, see, like in the beginning, there was no restrictions. Lot of restrictions was there, but there is no particular board was not there. So they made, government has made a special board for controlling the buying and selling of the securities and other related activities. So SEBI has been established. The restriction in respect of interest on debentures has been lifted. Now it is decided on the basis of the demand and supply. There were first there was earlier before this 1991, there was a restriction on the interest rates of the debentures. Okay, so it was a, like a fixed amount of debentures were means fixed amount of interest was given for the debentures, and after that this this has been removed. And the interest on the debentures are now decided based on the demand and supply. Okay, so how much debentures are there and how much demand is there, based on that the interest rates are set. Then next one, private sector has been permitted to establish mutual funds. So earlier only government mutual funds were there, and even after that the even for the government sorry even for private sector the mutual funds were permitted. The mutual funds were able to be created by the private industry, private companies also. Okay, so these are the capital market reforms. The next point that we have to study is called dismantling price control. The government has the steps to remove has taken steps to remove price control in case of many products. Price control means that the companies will sell goods at the prices determined by the government. So earlier there was a price restrictions was there, price control was there. So the earlier the products was the price of the product was decided by the government, and the companies had to decide the price. Companies cannot decide the price. Company has to sell the product in the government determined prices. But this control was removed, and after that the private sector, private companies were given permission for deciding the price of the product. So what happens is that when government sets the price, then they will sell the product on the given price, but they will not improve the quality. Okay, so they will try to reduce the quality. Now see, like if a product is coming in the market, they increase the price and try to increase the quality. Okay, so that they will create a good demand for the product. But earlier what system was that they produce a product and the price is fixed. Like if one product cost is 100 rupees, so if the quality of the product will be, they will be reducing the raw materials quality or other quality of the product may be reduced. So in order to get a more profit, so there is no much benefit, and there is no competition between the companies. All products, all companies are selling the products on the same price, so there will not be much amount of competition. Its quality, slightly competition will be there, but in order to make more profit, the companies reduce the quality of the product. So and afterwards the this kind of limitation has been removed, and private companies have given permission to decide the price, at what price the products of the company has to be sold. The efforts to remove price control were mostly in respect of fertilizers, steel and iron, and petro products. So these type of products are there, like fertilizers, steel and iron, and the petro products. So these products price control was removed. Okay, so the fertilizers and all. So these type of products, mostly the government was controlling the price. Even now, see, like the petrol prices, petrol and diesel price is determined by the government now also. Okay, so because otherwise, and you know that the somewhat almost similar price is there all throughout the country. So slight 1 rupee or slight variation in the price is there according to different places, or even some companies may sell the product like when you consider this SR petrol pump is there, there the price of the product is slightly higher. Or Reliance petrol pumps are there, there also the price is slightly different. So according to different petrol pumps, the price will be slight difference, means less than 1 rupee or around 1 rupee variation only will be there. The remaining price is controlled by the price is determined by the government. And now the petrol price has been determined every day. So according to the demand and supply, the price is determined on every day. So earlier there was so much restriction on the price determination, and the government has decided to remove all these type of restrictions. So these are the major steps taken by the government for the economic reforms. In order to bring up the economic reforms, the steps that has been taken by the government. So this is a very important topic that we have to study. So you may go forward with this one, you study this. And hope you all are studying the topics which I am teaching. And I found that only very few students are watching the videos which I am sending. Or I don't know whether you are watching and not making comment, because I am unable to see whether you are watching it or not. So you just inquire about your friends. Only 6-7 students are watching, I found. And now I am uploading the videos in YouTube. So you can go through the YouTube, and whenever I upload the channel, and if you have any comments regarding the videos, then you can make the comments under the comment box, either in YouTube or in Google Classroom. I will be uploading the link of the video on the YouTube videos link. I will be sending in a Google Classroom. So I suppose that it is finding easy for you to watch it, because when I am trying to upload the video, if it is slightly bigger in size, then I am finding it difficult to upload in Google Classroom. That is why I started to upload the videos in YouTube. So in this like there is no much restrictions regarding the size of the videos. Any amount of videos or any number of videos can be uploaded, and up to any size we can upload the videos. So I hope that you are enjoying the videos, and keep on studying, continue with your studies, because you are in 12th class. You may be thinking that the exams may not be there or a class may not be there, so that is why we are going to escape. Okay, so but you don't consider like that. So this year is a crucial year for you. So 12th class, so there are also so many problems are there, and you are getting a lot amount of time at your home for studies. Okay, so spend the time for studies, and even though there is like some relaxation in exams may be there, but these things are very much necessary for your future. So the things that we are studying, the things that you are studying in 11th and 12th is a base for your future. So when you go for degree or PG or anything like that, then these things are very much essential. So you each topics you may study, understand properly, and continue. And if you find some difficulty in any topics, you please make me a comment either in WhatsApp or Google Classroom or even in YouTube. You can make comments there, and I will be clearing your doubts. If you are having any doubts regarding this or any kind of questions are there that you have to ask, you can ask it. Okay, thank you so much.